So today we will be studying Michaelis-Menten equation, and this equation is used to determine the rate of reaction which are catalyzed by enzymes. So first of all, we will see the mechanism. Mechanism proposed is enzyme combines with substrate to give us enzyme substrate complex, which further gives us product. So this is a two-step mechanism. The first step is a reversible step. So for the forward reaction, we are taking rate constant as K1, and for backward reaction as K2, and for the second step, we are taking rate constant as K2. Alright, in order to determine the rate of reaction, how do we write the rate of reaction? Change in concentration of product with respect to time, that we write. And if we consider this second step only, our rate of reaction will be rate constant into concentration of our reactant, and reactant in the second step is enzyme substrate complex. So let's suppose this is our first equation, but we do not know the concentration of enzyme substrate complex. So in order to find out the enzyme substrate complex, we will be applying steady state approximation. And to understand the steady state approximation, let's say we have a time concentration graph of the reactants of our reactant product and our intermediate. So what happens with time? The concentration of our reactant decreases, the concentration of our product increases. But the concentration of our enzyme substrate complex, it first increases and then becomes steady. Alright, so this is enzyme substrate, this is our product, and this is our substrate. Alright, so this plot, this suggests that the change in concentration of our enzyme substrate complex with respect to time is zero. Alright, or in other words, we can say the rate of formation of enzyme substrate complex is equal to the rate of decomposition. And from the mechanism, if we find out the rate of formation of enzyme substrate, this would be equal to K1, concentration of our free enzyme, and concentration of our substrate. Alright, and the rate of decomposition, if we consider this mechanism, the backward step takes place when enzyme substrates decomposes to give us enzyme and substrate. So our rate of decomposition will become K inverse concentration of our enzyme substrate complex. And also the second step. In the second step, enzyme substrate complex is being converted to product. So the K2ES. Alright. Now this enzyme is actually the free enzyme, and we can write it in terms of total enzyme concentration minus enzyme substrate complex. This becomes equal to K inverse enzyme substrate concentration K2ES. Now we will take all the enzyme substrate terms on one side and remaining terms on the other side. On applying the mathematical manipulation, we can find out the concentration of enzyme substrate in terms of known factors. So here we will be taking our enzyme substrate complex common, and the remaining term will be K1 concentration of substrate plus K inverse plus K2. and here we have K1 ETS. Therefore, the concentration of enzyme substrate complex becomes K1 ET substrate K1S plus K inverse plus K2. Alright. Now, on further manipulating this, or we can say by multiplying and dividing our dividing our numerator and denominator by K1, we will get a further simplified equation. If we divide the numerator by K1, this K1 will be cancelled out and we'll have this in our numerator, and here substrate plus K inverse plus K2 divided by K1. This we will get as an equation. Now, let's suppose this is our equation third. In our equation first, the rate of reaction was equal to K2 concentration of ES. And in the third equation, we find out the concentration of ES in terms of known factors. So we will be putting value of concentration of ES from equation third into equation one. We get rate of reaction is equal to our K2 ET S divided by substrate concentration plus K inverse plus K2 divided by K1. Alright, now if we see all these three rate constants, the name itself suggests these three are constants. So in place of three constants, we are bringing a new constant named Km. Plus Km, where Km is equal to K inverse plus K2 divided by K1, and this Km is known as Michaelis constant.